It's Wednesday, December 15. Coming up live on The View. The hot topics are scandalous. From latest celeb divorces mean that Hollywood marriages have a two-year itch. And what had Sherry wigging out at The View's Christmas party last night? Plus, Jenny McCarthy's telling the co-host how she's handling a double dose of breakups, what it's like having Charlie Sheen as a boyfriend, and how she's spending New Year's Eve with Ryan Seacrest. If I die young. And country superstars The Band Perry is bringing their Alabama sound up north when they perform their Grammy-nominated hit on The View. All that, hot topics and more, coming up live on The View.
Fester this morning. Hello and welcome to The View. Okay. I'm totally Uncle Fester this morning. That's except for the shoes.
Isn't there, what about Cousin It? Is that a different show?
It is all hair.
Wait, let me see the shoes.
Cousin It is all hair.
It's Fester up top. Click your heels three times.
I can't imagine that I'm dressed this way because we had our annual View Christmas party yesterday.
Is that... You're in mourning for it, is that it?
I think I might not have understood what I was doing when I got dressed. I think it just
I think everybody's kind of a little tired because...
I know, tell me about it because I missed it. The kids were sick.
The kids were sick. It was a good time. We danced. I think we got a shot of Barbara getting her boogie on because Barbara was out there jamming on the floor, her and Bill Getty.
Look at Bill.
And that particular dance was to Single Ladies. So Barbara actually pulled Bill out, and we were dancing to Single Ladies. So we danced on it. But this is the one thing I have to say about the dancing. I am really proud of white people because, Whoopi, you know, normally we have something, black people, we have something called the electric slide, the cha-cha slide, you know, all kinds of dances. And normally when we do those, white people always look and they go, I wanna, oh gosh, I'm so sorry, I can't. And we do it in unison. But it was more white people out on the floor doing the to the left, one time, hop. And I mean, white people just like, yeah. People took it over, the cha-cha slide.
Just for trying does not get credit. You have to have rhythm.
No, but they did it. I'm gonna give you credit. It was black people, we were just like, yeah.
And she says this like there's a whole bunch of us. There were like five of us in here. I mean, come on, you know, we try to applaud whatever we can. Yes. They give us a little love, we give them some love. Now, you know, if you have kids in the room, you need to tell them to maybe leave the room for this because there's a shocking video of a gunman storming a Florida school board meeting, and his gunfire didn't hit anyone, thank God. Yes. And he eventually, you know, took himself out. But before that, one very brave woman called Ginger Littleton tried to disarm him with her purse. You know, I mean, this is crazy. And you see Ginger coming in.
Yes, mommy.
She's trying to hit him with her pocketbook.
She's trying to make him drop the gun.
Look at
that. But he did not, he didn't
shoot her.
He didn't shoot anybody. He didn't shoot anybody. There are holes in the walls. Yes. He was shot in the leg. It was just, it was insane. But
his wife had gotten fired.
That's what he said. But they, you know, I was listening to the gentleman talk who the gun was aimed at, and he said, we didn't understand anything that he was talking about. We don't know if his wife was fired. We don't know if he even knew what he was talking about, so.
Well, the superintendent or the school board chief, he was saying to him, I remember hearing this, I'm the one who fired her. Leave everybody else alone. There was quite a bit of bravery going on,
There's
I thought, in that room.
Bravery, and, you
it's
know,
incredible to hear that.
Going with your pocketbook, she should have had a gun, you know, maybe.
But no. See, now, you know, it just shows you the
Second Amendment, maybe.
The fact that her bravery that she came back because she said she ran out and she came back, but the state of some folks' frustration yeah. you know, that they would do something.
Oh, that they're out of work and everything.
Well, it's terrible. We'll see if it's his frustration or whether this was a man who was ill. You know, he had all the women and children leave. This is how she, the first lady, left. But he left one woman at the end of the table. So it's just, it's very crazy, but yeah. thank God nobody was hurt, and sadly for his family, they don't have him, so our prayers go to them.
Yeah,
now, this is also another nutty story. An armed gunman stormed into the Bellagio Casino in Las Vegas and walked out with around $1.5 million worth of casino chips. Now, wait.
He is wearing a motorcycle helmet.
Now, casino reps say it was all for nothing because electronic devices in the chips will make them very hard to cash in.
He has to go back to the Bellagio. You can't go to the Caesars and cash in Bellagio chips. But more importantly, I'd be scared to be messing with Vegas casinos.
Exactly. Did you not see Ocean's 11?
Thank you.
Clearly he didn't understand it.
It's like going into a bank and stealing the deposit slips.
Yeah.
What are you going to do with this?
And really think that those works. I thought, whoa, I have so much money.
35,
I
was like, yeah.
But he will have to have, literally, he would have to have somebody helping him because he'd have to really go, Joy, I'm going to give you $5,000, go in and cash him.
But here's the thing, he took huge denominations. See, if I don't know anything about thieving, but
if you did,
if I were a thief, I would have grabbed all the 10 and 25s because those are easier to dispose of.
Oh.
A $25,000 chip. From another casino, you can't take it anywhere but to that casino.
And then they're still gonna be watching.
It's the hello?
But they're not. It's on that theory, though, when somebody.
Chips are branded. They have a picture of Caesar and this one and that one.
Sometimes you can interdo them, but I think it's only to a certain amount. But $25,000, you know, $25,000 chip, and you come in with three of them.
It's like when somebody steals your credit card, right? So you're saying the larger money's marked and they know about it and they'll check into it. Whereas somebody steals your credit card, they make a dollar purchase here, $4 here, $5 here. So you don't necessarily know.
Because it happens. Didn't it happen to somebody on staff the other day when he left? And they called him as he left the restaurant and someone just used your card.
He wasn't all the way prepared. That was such the preparation.
Who?
The guy who stole the chips.
Oh,
like he didn't think all that through.
No, he was thinking big. He just wasn't thinking.
Yeah, but
he
didn't think it out.
I was watching a program about people stealing your password the other day, and they were saying that those five numbers or letters and numbers is not good. You have to have like 12 now it's very hard to tap into it.
Sure.
And they suggest that you do a sentence like "I love my husband" or "I hate my husband," whatever you want. But that's a good, a sentence, and that will be a password.
Yeah,
just a tip
birthday.
They
don't have to steal my stuff, because, you know, every place needs a password. You got to remember that password. There's 500 different passwords. You got it written down on the wall. The government, everybody's in there looking, the people working for you. Like, oh, there's your password.
But if it's a phrase, it might be easier to remember.
But you got to change it.
Why can't you use that on all the time?
No, you got to change it every few months.
I hate my wife this month. I love my wife next month.
Well, speaking of love and hate, Time Magazine voted Facebook's Mark Zuckerberg as a person of the year.
Yeah.
But readers voted for WikiLeaks head Julian Assange.
Right. Well, he's more influential. I mean, one year Time Magazine had Hitler. You know, so it's not necessarily the most popular person. But this guy is internationally influential, but so is Zuckerberg.
I mean, I was looking at the stats here. I think it's one out of every 10 people on the planet have a Facebook account. Every minute, 1.7 billion interactions take place.
Yeah.
I think on that little sort of like not moving scale, like Mark Zuckerberg is influential. But I think over time, in terms of security, wars, et cetera, I think Assange will end up being the most
important. Well, because his leaks have to do with international, things that are very important.
Security.
It's really difficult things. The Friends book is nice.
So my
Friends
book is more popular.
But it is. The Facebook is...
It's like the Amish Facebook.
The
Friends book.
I think it's the influence worldwide that it's having on your life and my life. Because, the impact on individual people as opposed to the larger whole. I think that's what Times
thing was.
Is it hot in there, or am I having a
flare? No, it's not you.
It's before, remember?
It's not you.
Before she's saying, I think they turned the air conditioners on without your conditioner.
No, it's warm. It's really warm.
But now it's hot.
It's a little hot. I'm dressed as Uncle Fester.
Yeah, no, it's...
You know what?
I can't even do that.
I don't know why I'm so silly today, but it's going to continue. We'll be right back with more Hot Topics and, oh, bring the kids back in the room. Scarlett Johansson and Ryan Reynolds announced they're divorcing after 2 years of marriage. Now, does it seem that 2 years seems to be the hurdle?
The hurdle.
In this instance, they were saying it was the distance because she was over here doing her thing and he was over here doing his thing. I don't think that helps the distance.
Sometimes it does.
It really does.
Absolutely.
It makes a heart grow fonder. Did you ever hear that?
It makes it grow fonder, but then, you know, when you got to do the work and you get together.
But see, if you...
I thought it said abstinence makes the heart grow fonder.
That
it does. That it does.
No, but you know, years ago, it used to be the 7-year itch, but that was when people didn't have sex before they got married. Now they're having it a year ahead, usually, and so they're still hot for each other. They say, oh, let's get married. It'll be great. And then 2 years later, they're like, who are you?
So then maybe...
But we have...
Maybe no sex before marriage would prolong the marriage.
It doesn't. It only prolongs it maybe for another year. That's all.
But look who... What, Eva Longoria and Tony Parker, they lasted 3 years. Charlie Sheen and his wife, Brooke Mueller, 2 years.
They were married a long time. They didn't just...
Charlie Sheen and Brooke Mueller,
11 years.
No,
this was a new one that Charlie Sheen got.
Richards, Denise...
Courtney Cox and David Arquette was 11 years. But Charlie Sheen and Brooke Mueller, because he was married to somebody else, and then Denise Richards, and then,
oh, I see.
You know.
Right. Yeah.
And Sandra Bullock and Jesse James were 5 years.
I didn't even know he was still married to her.
Yeah.
I tell you, I'm so behind all of this. I don't know.
I know. I didn't even know they were not together.
But you know what? I think if you don't know the person that you're marrying, that you haven't spent time... You know, I like courting, because courting helps you know somebody. You get to spend time. I like courting for 2 years.
Right.
You know, I think you should court somebody before you marry them. I'm speaking from experience. I love a wedding. I love the party. Yeah. Everybody's so happy when you get married.
Right.
It's the day after that I have an issue.
I feel your pain.
You know?
I feel your pain.
You know, I can't do it. So I don't know.
I think most people, if they were honest with themselves and really understood they're not in for marriage, maybe wouldn't do it, right? Is that what you're saying?
Because sometimes, you know, guys won't say that because they don't want to lose the girl, you know? But if, and, you know, we've had this conversation before. If somebody is a player, or depending on where you're from, if somebody is a player, you have to figure that instinct does not go away.
It
just doesn't.
Right.
So you have to be aware of this.
You remember yesterday when Diddy was here, because we talked to Diddy about the women in his life, you know, and Diddy was saying, and I think... His baby mamas. But he was saying that he was in love with these women, and when one broke his heart, he went to this one, and when they broke his heart, he went to that one. And I think you got to listen... So when a man is saying what he's saying.
I love his song, too. I mean, when he talks about, I'm coming home, and he talks about talking to his girls about why he didn't...
His twins, what is he going to say when his twins say, why didn't you marry my mom?
What's the answer to the song?
It's my run mix.
There's no answer.
You know, anthropologic... in evolution, this is from Helen Fisher, who is an anthropologist.
Right.
She writes, basically, I think this, if I'm quoting her correctly, the species needs to procreate, and it needs to go on. So... Nature provides for a huge sex drive for 2 years so that you can have children. After that, nature says, bye.
Yeah, but some people...
And, you know, nature doesn't need you anymore. So you have to now start working on the relationship.
Yes, you really do.
And that's the part nobody likes to do.
Yes. Yeah. Well, you have to work on the relationship before the sex.
Bottom line is you get totally lazy in a relationship.
If you wait 2 years, the sex will diminish, and then you'll see if you really like the person.
Well, that's what you need to do, but most people don't.
It doesn't diminish for the man, though.
It diminishes for you. It doesn't diminish for the mutant. down the block.
But I'm saying men, if you ask men, I'm not saying that they're all nymphomaniacs. Men, you know, but not men are not nymphomaniacs, but men's sex drive still lasts longer because I don't know if they can have babies longer because their sperm at 90, a man can still have a child.
Well, with Viagra, we'll be faking orgasms into our golden years.
You're kind of right.
I mean, this stupid drug is driving women to mental institutions.
But you're right, because here, women desire intimacy, right? Women want to be intimate and then they want sex, for the most part, right? Yeah. And for the most part, with the exception, men feel intimacy after because of sex. The sex is their, like, means to intimacy, whereas women, I think, want it and then have sex.
A lot, it's a lot of it is a validation as well. Sex, when you say to a man, I read somewhere that I don't want sex, I don't want to have sex, they're looking at it like, you don't want me. Yeah. So, but they're sex
drive. Well, but you know what? We're all adults here, for the most part, you know, and the bottom line is, you know, you have to learn about her body, she has to learn about yours. And if you don't talk, because most women will not talk to their old man, they'll just say, you know, I'm having a hot flash. They don't explain what also that means. Mm-hmm. They don't explain what happens and what goes on. So it's not something you go through together. And somehow now you're over here saying no, no, no. And he's kind of going, but what's wrong? Is there nothing? You know, because you all drama and drugs. You know, it's not easy. But
they should have one of those things like babycenter.com. They tell you at this week your baby does this and wants this. At, you know, menopause, women want this.
People
send it
don't.
To
you know what? People
email.
Don't want to talk about it. They don't want to talk about the things that come with it. You know, I sneezed the other day, had to change my clothes. Listen, let me ask you.
Funny, I did the same thing.
Tell me, what's up with Gracie?
Oh, Grace is
what's
funny.
Happening with Grace?
You know what? In this time, we have we get together with a bunch of our friends, and I saw her playing with one of her girlfriends, and they had this awesome conversation. And one of them said, "Oh, Grace said, oh, I have a Christmas tree, and it's, we're celebrating baby Jesus is coming." And her friend said, "I'm Jewish. We don't have that. We don't have that." And Grace said, "Well, this is our nativity." And then they both said, "Well, we just have different things. That's cool." And they just went on with life in a way that was so understanding. And I thought adults have a really hard time during this time saying, "Okay, I'm at a store. If there's a tree, there should be a menorah. If there should be a jar of nothing." Cool. And I thought kids just have the perfect perspective of, that's great. That's what you do. I love you anyway. Who cares? Let's have a cookie. You know, it was just easy and over and done.
That's why they say that hate. Yeah. Well, that's right. Hate is taught. Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Those questions about other people's religions are taught. That's learned behavior. Yeah. So it's on all of us. We're, you know, saying stuff we think the kids can't hear. Ha-ha. They hear everything. Yeah, they and you know what, Sherry? What's up with the boy?
Oh, with Jeffrey, it's so funny because his teacher said it's really important that Jeffrey has the play dates. And I'm going, oh, God, with these play dates. And so I met a lady who had twins, and they were so cute. And they said, oh, we want to be with JJ, and Jeffrey wanted to be with them. So I invited them to go to a screening. We went to see Gulliver's Travels because the twins were so cute. They got in the car with us. I swear we got off of Times Square. One twin went this way. One twin went that way. It was a band setting up. The twins went underneath the rope, kicking the drums. And, I mean, I'm running. And then Jeffrey saw him. He was like, shoot, if they can do it. My son, I see a red Parker taking off down the thing with
what
the twins. I'm running and I'm going, Robert. And then his mom's like, no, no, that's Ann. I'm like, I don't care. Twin number one. Get over it. And I used to want twins. I did fertility treatments because I was like, get it out the way. I take my hat off to you people who have twins and triplets.
Oh, triplets, forget about it.
Anybody who has a kid, you take your hat off to them, because raising a kid is not easy. Now, listen, I just want to put this out because he was on our show. You remember when Leon Russell came on and he was with Elton? Well, Leon Russell, who received the Musical Excellence Award from the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Congrats. That means he's going into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
This is a guy who's been around a long time. And we love it, and we love him. And we're going to go and come right back with even more Hot Topics because we're deep. So, you know, if you haven't gotten dressed yet this morning, listen up. Wearing an ugly pair of underwear can ruin your entire day. No, it's true. About half of women polled in a consumer survey said their undies make all the difference in how confident they feel that day.
that's
now,
true.
Now, I know that sounds that, crazy, that's
true. That's true.
But I, who said I was wearing it?
Oh, I'm sorry.
You know what? It's so funny.
What are you gonna do?
They want to check, inspect.
It's so funny because that is so true. When I played a Brad Garrett's partner on Everybody Loves Raymond, mm-hmm. and they dressed me up as this cop, and I felt so like unfeminine. And I used to wear a thong every single time because I was like, I gotta do something to just make me feel a little sexy underneath this cop. You said you weren't wearing
it. Did it work? Huh. No.
Did it work? Yes.
No,
it worked.
I said, what makes you think? Because Joy turned and said, you do. That's right. But here's the thing.
But it didn't help.
Here's an old story. The Ziegfeld Follies, years and years and years ago. You remember that group of women were on the stage, and it was beautiful, and they were tall and gorgeous. Florence Ziegfeld was forever in debt to people because he ordered their underwear from Paris to be handmade for each of those Ziegfeld girls, and there were quite a few of them. And so his manager said, what are you doing? You are breaking us. And he said, no, this is the right thing to do. And the manager said, what are you talking about? He said, I could give them regular old underwear, and that's how they'd go up the stairs. But when they know they're wearing hand-sewn underwear from France, they move differently.
Yeah, absolutely. Wow.
So maybe there is something to that.
Yeah, instead of those big bloomers that you can run the credits for the show on. Those are very attractive.
Yeah, men don't like those too much.
No, mm-hmm. not
yeah, but
really.
You know what? I have to tell you, the thong thing freaks me out.
No,
why?
Have you tried hanky panky?
I have tried.
No, listen, the hanky panky.
I lose them. There are 65 thongs. I could do a whole flag on a ship if they pulled them out.
Look. She's got thongs and Jimmy Hoffa up there. Someday they'll find everybody.
They'll find everybody. Joy.
Yes.
Tell everybody who's coming on your HLN show tonight.
Well, tonight on my HLN show, we're having the biggest loser as a guest. You know, the guy who lost 170-something pounds.
Oh.
I want to get some tips on what to do this Christmas, because I cannot stop eating.
Not for Christmas. You're not trying to lose weight.
Do it after. The holidays. You have to be careful now. You could gain 10 pounds between now and New Year's.
Here's the deal. You're going to try to lose it after anyway, right?
So
take a month and then lose it in a month.
I don't want to gain it and then have to lose it again. I'm sick of the whole thing.
Embrace it. It's not only the 10 pounds that we would have to lose. It's just weight. So, I mean, have
That's
fun.
Right. Embrace the weight.
Yes. Just during this season.
I'm tired of embracing my age, my weight, everything they want me to embrace.
The older we get, we have to embrace more.
Yeah.
This is what I understand.
You said you were going to embrace everything.
Maya Angelou was at that AARP thing the other night. She's so cute. And she was just saying, you're going to embrace it. And I'm thinking, I don't want to embrace it. She's 82 now. She's embracing.
That's
right. Yeah.
And she is just the craziest woman in the world.
She is.
We love you, Maya. Sherry, what's up?
Michael Jackson had a lot more to give before we tragically lost him. In a brand new CD, Michael has never before heard songs by the King of Pop. And members of our studio audience are going home with a copy.
Very nice. Very nice. Well, we'll be right back with Jenny McCall.
Jenny McCarthy. First, she breaks up with Jim Carrey, then Charlie Sheen on Monday Night's 2.5 Men. Now she has a New Year's date with Ryan Seacrest. And this girl somehow still found time to help kids and their parents sleep better at night. So please welcome back Jenny McCarthy. You have been having the busiest year. Congratulations to you. But we gotta start with your breakup with Jim Carrey, because we saw pictures of you everywhere. We thought you guys would be together forever.
I know, we were like Joni and Chachi to so many people.
Yeah. How long were you together?
We were together 5 years.
Yeah.
And in Hollywood standards, that's like 20.
Yeah.
And it was a wonderful relationship. You know, we ended in peace, unlike a lot of couples. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I'm so grateful for all the lessons he taught me, but...
What did he teach you? Like what?
You know, You know, people always want to know, like, what happened? Why did you break up? I'm not going to get into specifics, but I have learned a spiritual tool, which is I wrote down everything that I blamed him. Like, I would say, he blank, 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 he blank, blank, blank. And there was, like, 20 things on a list. So then I crossed out his name and put I.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
And I was like, oh, God. And I went through the list of I did this, I wasn't giving you this, and really did the work on myself and realized, oh, whatever we're kind of blaming our partner for not filling our potholes, we kind of have to be responsible for filling our own.
If you don't do that, I agree with that completely because I did the same thing. If you don't do that, you will never be able to have another. I believe you will never go on to the next one.
That's right.
In a successful manner.
If you don't want to take a look at
if
why you...
don't take the blame for your part.
Sure, it's true. Because it's so much easier, and I think that that's what my pattern was all these years, is really kind of blaming. Like, I will devote and give my whole heart to somebody I love, but then I expect so much from them.
Yeah. Expectations.
Oh, they're huge. Yeah.
But do you think that the marriage would have lasted longer if you had done that work, both of you, during the marriage?
Well, they weren't married.
We weren't married, but probably. Well, I think any couple that goes in, and really Byron Katie is this awesome spiritual teacher. It's called The Work, thework.com, and she gives you those tools. I think no matter what, if you have that kind of communication with your partner, and like I said, not hold those expectations. I mean, my God, what I was doing to guys in my head, you know.
Sure. I still most women do that.
They
do. Like what were you doing?
Well, you know, you go on the first date, and you immediately you picture
it's
the
too
wedding.
Short.
No, I'm going like, boom. And I'm like, this is how he's going to be. Oh. And I have this whole soap opera scenario of how this man's going to be. And then as the relationship goes on, he's not meeting this fairy tale. And, you know, and then I get mad. And I'm like, oh, I can understand, you know. Yeah. It's like, how can anyone compete with that?
Watch the soap operas, it tells you what's coming.
That's,
you
know?
That's true. So that's true.
So now we fast forward, and after you dated Jim, you dated Jason Tuwi.
I was having a little bit of fun around
town. You guys were dating. He's a model and a Vegas performance. After 4 months, it was reported that you guys had broken up.
Right. I mean, is this one anymore?
No.
That's all the pictures that you have of all these guys with you.
Well, let me just tell you something. I'm not really like a serial dater. I'm like, I go into a relationship for like 7 years. Yeah. So this is like my first time since I was like 12 of being single. I'm not kidding. So, you know, people might go like, oh, you're around town with guys, but really, you know, I deserve it. I'm having fun. I'm being picky now. I'm not forcing that fantasy.
So you're like Elizabeth Taylor, who always
I'm just not getting married. I only got married once. Not
you
bad.
You know, the tabloids are following you around. Does it bug you when they are so invasive in your life?
Well, you know, I'm always amazed. I'm like, who cares who I'm dating? Like, I can't wait to see who Ryan Reynolds dates. I'm going to be like, But, you know, with me, I think, why does anyone care? But does it bother me? Yeah, because you don't really know the truth about what's going on. Mm. But I love it, looking at it and talking about it like you guys do, so I can't be too upset about it.
That's good.
I want to ask about a fictitious breakup. You joined the cast of Two and a Half Men and played Charlie Sheen's girlfriend. Broke up this past Monday. Done. So does that mean no more appearances? Or are you coming back?
I've done 6 episodes of the show. They didn't kill me, so I take it as I might be back. Uh-huh. I had a great time in the show. It was a fun character to play. She was a real user, and unlike myself, a girl that likes diamonds, I can care less about them. But we had a really great time. He's a good guy, and everyone wanted to know if there was issues.
Right, because everyone's saying the show is still successful despite things that we've seen about Charlie in the media and the news.
His issues are not with the show or on
not
the show.
All,
it's after the show.
So people assume naturally, it must affect his work.
Well, it was right after the big, you know, media spin. I had to go onto the set. And, you know, everyone called me later to say what was it like. And like, he was great, you know.
You're a good one for making folks smile.
Well, you know what? I feel like I'm a dog. I'm like a Cocker Spaniel on a set. I will balance any kind of energy, you know, but he was so super cool, sweet. And I gotta tell you, like, you know, off camera, like when I watch Charlie Sheen, I'd be like, oh, he's all right. But in person, you can see why girls dig him. He does exude this like sexual energy that you go, oh, I see why they want to kind of go over there. But not shy. We just had a great time working.
I hear that you're getting your own talk show.
In development with Harpo. If not, I'm gonna join the cast of The View.
You have to get rid of one of us.
Yes, I'm in development, so we will see. You know, I've done like we've done pilots together over the past few years.
Well, we keep that
we've done sitcom pilots.
worked together quite a bit.
Yes, and now I feel like ready to, you know, I feel like I'm a mom and I have a lot to say and I want to, you know, be able to say what I want, and that's how I can do it without being in character. I know, I know. We'll be less.
And New Year's Eve, you're doing Dick Clark, Ryan Seacrest, rocking New Year's Eve, right?
I'm gonna freeze my butt off.
You totally are. You got to plan that outfit. You got to layer.
I don't know what I'm gonna do.
Oh, some cute.
Because you want to look cute, but you don't want to freeze.
I'm probably gonna wear what you would wear to climb Mount Everest.
Yes.
Like just a parka this big.
Or no, just get some. You know, on the sets, what they do when you're working outside in the cold. Get those. The silks.
Leggings. Oh, yeah.
Get the silks, and then you can be as fly as you want.
Well, they have me in the pit of people, so hopefully the body heat and their alcohol will keep me warm.
So do you make New Year's resolutions?
Because you know what? Do you?
Because I try, but it doesn't work.
Yeah, the
I
only
sort of get around to them in April.
It's just a pain in the butt, because it's like after the wedding day, it's like you get disappointed. As soon as you fail, it's like, ugh. But the only thing I can think of is that I want to feel more present in my life instead of being out in my imagination.
Well, how are you going to do that?
By concentrating, like as soon as I see my mind go, come back to here.
Well, something that you are going to be present about, which is really great. You just recently started a children's bedding and accessory line called Too Good. Now, tell us about it.
I am so excited. So all you pregnant mamas, listen up. This is 2 years in the making. I designed a baby bedding line that's affordable, safer, fashionable. I was sick of all the rich people getting the good stuff.
Yeah.
So now, you know, you can find it in your neighborhood, Bye-Bye Baby, Baby Depot, and we're really proud of it. You know, it's durable. One of the things that we asked moms, what drives you crazy about your baby bedding is, you know, you bring it home, you wash it once.
And then it shrinks.
And then you like try to fit it over the crib and it doesn't fit. So we tested that. We test for banned chemicals like mercury and lead. Right. So crib safety is so important to me.
Yeah.
And I just hope that moms check out the line because I put my name on it, which means I care about it. I want to go show it to you. Can we go?
We can go.
Okay, go,
definitely.
Go.
I would love to see it. Come on.
This one is called Zuzu, and it's got a comforter that's reversible.
It's so cute.
Along with the bumpers that are reversible, which is so good because you know how we get bored and sick of things
and
so
you
quickly.
You want to change it up.
It's true. And then the cotton sheets, you know, anywhere your baby face lays on is cotton.
I love it.
Isn't
okay.
It?
Yeah.
So cute.
This is great.
This one is $99, 5-piece set. It won't break the bank and still it looks so cute. Look
and
at you,
I like this little hamper. I like the leopard.
I know.
This
isn't
is
cute?
Great. Yes, now what else do we have?
Then over here we have a love bug. This is a 9-piece set.
These right here?
No,
little
the draperies,
decor, decor. We hung up the comforters so you can see, but they are reversible.
For the entire room.
It's so cute. You know, not to get too serious, but the crib safety part is so important. Evan's first seizure, I found him in his crib. So since then, you know, ventilation has been imperative to me.
Of course.
So that's why the cotton sheets I love. The four-piece, you know, bumpers are really essential for that, too. So if you want to find out more about crib safety, you know, one of the things that we're talking about is cribsafety.org gets a piece of the proceeds along with Generation Rescue. So I hope people do find out and take a look at Too Good.
Well, this is great. I love Too Good.
Thank you, Jenny, for coming.
We love it when you come because you balance everything out.
Yeah, right?
Thanks
to
Jenny McCarthy. So that members of our studio audience can check out Jenny's bedding line, you are all taking home a $100 gift card from Bye Bye Baby. When we come back, the band Perry is performing their Grammy-nominated hit.
Or I got to try to get it all in there.
First Grammy nomination for Country Song of the Year. Here to perform their nominated hit, If I Die Young, off their self-titled debut album. Please welcome the band Perry.
If I die young, bury me in satin, lay me down on a bed of roses, sing me in the river at dawn, send me away with the words of a love song. So no, I'm safe with you, and she stands under my colors. Oh, and laughing always was. I'll sell them for a dollar. They're worth so much more after I'm a goner. And maybe then you'll hear the words I've been singing. Funny when you're dead, how people start to listen.
Fudge Stripes cookies. Their rich chocolatey fudge makes every bite uncommonly good. And Apple and Eve for providing them with a bottle of their delicious 100% pure juice.
Now, you know, it seems to me, I'm not going to say this to you guys, it seems to me every time I see a new group, they look younger and younger. They look like little kids to me.
Yeah. Yeah.
I was like, they're like babies.
So it's not because you're getting older and older, is it?
Yeah, it's them. Listen, have a great day. Take a little time to enjoy the what?
Yeah.